Good morning, dear students. How are you all? I, Dr. Beena Karnatak, is going to start first chapter of your book, Footprints Without Feet. First chapter, that is, A Triumph of Surgery. And this chapter is written by James Herriot. Let's start with the title first. Triumph meaning victory. A victory of or a triumph of surgery. Surgery here refers to the treatment of a veterinary doctor. Let's have a short view of the story first. Tricky, a small dog, is pampered and overfed by his rich mistress. Mistress means owner. He falls seriously, very badly ill, and his mistress consults a veterinary surgeon. Veterinary meaning the doctor who treats animals. Does he perform an operation? Does the dog recover? So this is all about the story. And here we got our three major characters of this story. They are number one, Tricky, the dog, a small dog. Mistress, the owner, and her name is Mrs. Pamphrey. Later on you are going to meet her in detail. And the last important character of this story, a veterinary surgeon. So three important characters are there. Let's start the story. I is the narrator, the doctor, veterinary doctor here. I was really worried about Tricky this time. I had pulled up my car when I saw him in the street with his mistress, owner, as I have already told you. And I was shocked at his appearance. Once the narrator, the veterinary doctor, met Tricky in between somewhere in the road, street, he stopped his car because with his appearance, with his looks, Tricky was not looking well. He had become hugely fat, like a blotted sausage, a big piece of meat with a leg at each corner. Because Tricky had become so fat, so huge, that flesh was hanging around from his body and he was looking a big piece of meat. His eyes, bloodshot and rheumy, stared straight. Bloodshot meaning his eyes were looking red, and rheumy, the watery discharge from his eyes and from his nose. Ahead of his tongue lolled from his jaws and his tongue was out. Mrs. Pamphrey hastened to explain. Mrs. Pamphrey was the owner of Tricky the dog. He was so listless, lack of energy. Mr. Herriot, she told to the doctor that he had become a lack of energy. He seemed to have no energy. This was her findings about her dog. I thought he must be suffering from malnutrition. This was, she found out in the dog that this was her findings, that he was suffering with malnutrition. So I have been giving him some little extras between meals to build him up some malt and cod liver oil and a bowl of Horlicks at night to make him sleep. Nothing much really. See, these three words are very important. Nothing much really. Though she had started feeding him so many things, so many extra things, but she had such great love for her dog that she thought it was nothing much. She thought that was very natural. She was giving him absolutely correct diet. And did you cut down on the sweet things as I told you? Now, this was the question asked by the narrator or the veterinary doctor. He asked, had she cut down the sweet things? Because sweet things are not good for him. Oh, I did for a bit, but he seemed to be so weak, I had to relent. She said, initially I cut it down a little, but actually he had become so weak, so I had to carry on with his sweet things as well. He does love cream cakes and chocolates, so I can't bear to refuse him. It shows again his over-pampered nature for Tricky. She said, he loved chocolate cakes, so I couldn't say no. I looked down again at the little dog. That was the trouble. Tricky's only fault was greed. This was the problem with Tricky, he found out. As a doctor, he found out the problem very quickly because he was greedy for food. He had never been known to refuse food. Mrs. Pamphrey was overfeeding him each and every time. And he was so greedy for each and every food stuff that he never said no for anything. He would tackle a meat at any hour of the day or night. And I wondered about all the things Mrs. Pamphrey hadn't mentioned. The doctor understood the reality behind the problem of Tricky. Though Mrs. Harriet mentioned so many things whatever she was giving him, but the doctor knew that there were many what she didn't mention, but she was giving him. Are you giving him plenty of exercise? This was the another genuine question he asked her. Okay, if you are giving him lot many food step, what about the exercise part? Well, he has his little walks. Little walks, almost no walks. With me, as you can see. But Hodgkin, the gardener, has been down with lumbago, so there has been no ring throwing lately. Meaning for exercise also, she said, though he was going for little walks, but actually the gardener is not there to help him in that. That is why that is also not in practice so much. So we'll carry on the another paragraph in the next video. Thank you.